fresh hand, tender kiss, had once stolen night of bliss. One girl, one boy, some grief, some joy, memories are made of this. Don't forget the small moonbeam. Fold it lightly with a dream. Your lips and mine, two sips of wine. Memories are made of this. Then add the wedding bells, one house where lovers dwell, three little kids for the flavor. Stir carefully through the days, see how the flavor stays. These are the dreams you will savor.
The sweet, sweet memories you gave me.
You can't beat the memories you gave me. The
sweet, sweet memories you gave
me. You can't beat the memories you gave me. One man, one wife, one love through life. The sweet, sweet memories you gave me. You can't beat the memories you gave me. Memories are made of you. Memories are made of you.
You must remember that a kiss is still a kiss, a sigh, just a sigh. And the fundamental things apply as time goes by. And when two lovers woo, they still say I love you. On that you can rely. No matter what the future brings, as time goes by. Moonlight and love songs, never out of date. Hearts full of passion, jealousy and hate. Woman needs man, man must have his mate. That no can deny. It's still the same old story. Fight for love and glory. A case of do or die. And the world will always love lovers as time.
Thank you. please do all receive you once again. This place, in which we are now met, has been duly sanctioned according to law for the celebration of marriages. You are here to witness the joining in matrimony of Carl William Green and Dawn Elizabeth Fibus. If any person present knows of any lawful impediment to this marriage, you should declare it now. The purpose of marriage is that you may always love, care for, and support each other through all the joys and sorrows of life, and that love may be fulfilled in a relationship of permanent and continuing commitment. We trust that these things may come true for you both. Is your full name Carl William Green?
Yes.
Is your full name Dawn Elizabeth Piper? Yes. Before you pledge yourselves to each other in marriage, it's my duty to remind you of the solemn and lasting character of the vows you are about to make to each other. Marriage, according to the law of this country, is the union of one man with one woman, voluntarily entered into for life, to the exclusion of all others. And I'm going to ask each of you in turn to declare that you don't know of any lawful reason why you should not be married to each other. So Carl, if you'd like to repeat after me first. I do solemnly declare.
I do solemnly declare.
That I know not.
That I know not.
Of any lawful impediment.
Of any lawful impediment.
Why I, Carl William Green.
Why I, Carl William Green.
May not be joined in matrimony.
May not be joined in matrimony.
To Dawn Elizabeth Pybus.
To Dawn Elizabeth Pybus.
I do solemnly declare.
I do solemnly declare.
That I know not.
That I know not.
Of any lawful impediment.
Of any lawful impediment.
Why I, Dawn Elizabeth Pybus.
Why I, Dawn Elizabeth Pybus.
May not be joined in matrimony.
May not be joined in matrimony.
To Carl William Green.
To Carl William Green.
Now the solemn moment has come for Carl and Dawn to contract their marriage before you, their witnesses. So would you all like to stand at this point? And would you like to turn to face each other? And would you like to join? Can I ask you, Carl, to repeat after me once again? I call upon these persons here present.
I call upon these persons here present.
To witness that I, Carl William Green.
To witness that I, Carl William Green.
Do take thee, Dawn Elizabeth Pybus.
To take thee, Dawn Elizabeth Pybus.
To be my lawful wedded wife.
To be my lawful wedded wife.
To be loving, faithful and loyal.
To be loving, faithful and loyal.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
Dawn, I call upon these persons here present.
I call upon these persons here present.
To witness that I, Dawn Elizabeth Pybus.
To witness that I, Dawn Elizabeth Pybus.
Do take thee, Carl William Green.
To take thee, Carl William Green.
To be my lawful wedded husband.
To be my lawful wedded husband.
To be loving, faithful and loyal.
To be loving, faithful and loyal.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
And now we come to the giving of the wedding rings, which is the ancient and traditional way of sealing the contract you've just made with each other. So Carl, can I ask you first and foremost to put the ring on Dawn's finger? Keep hold of the hand and repeat after me again. I give you this ring.
I give you this ring.
As a token of my love.
As a token of my love.
And in recognition of our commitment to each other.
And in recognition of our commitment to each other.
And Don, would you like to do that?
I give you this ring.
As a token of my love.
As a token of my love.
And in recognition of our commitment to each other.
And in recognition of our commitment together.
Yes. Carl and Dawn, you've both made the declarations required by law and have made your own solemn promises to each other. Let us hope that this day will form a milestone in your lives which you'll look back on in the future with much love and happiness. It therefore gives me a very great pleasure to say that you are now husband and wife together.
Thank you.
Many congratulations to you both. Would you all like to be seated while the register's set?
Right, well, if you'll sign for it. Would you like to just orient the pen on there?
Sure.
Right. Yeah. If you sign this one first, then
right.
I can blot it.
Does I'm a full name?
Just your full, your normal signature.
Right.
That's lovely. The same again just there.
Good.
That's lovely.
Thank you.
All right, Dawn, would you like to do it? Would you just like to orientate the pen?
Times are certain times of day when all the citizens retire to take their clothes off and perspire. It's one of those rules the greatest fools obey, because the sun is far too sultry and one must avoid its ultraviolet ray. The natives grieve when the white men leave their huts, because they're obviously, definitely nuts. mad dogs and Englishmen go out in the midday sun. The Japanese don't care to, the Chinese wouldn't dare to. Hindus and Argentines sleep firmly from 12 to 1. But Englishmen detest our siesta. In the Philippines, they have lovely screens to protect you from the glare. In the Malay states, there are hats like plates which the Britishers won't wear. At 12 noon, the natives swoon and no further work is done. But mad dogs and Englishmen go out in the midday sun. It's such a surprise for the Eastern eyes to see. But though the English are effete, they're quite impervious to heat. When the white man rides, every native hides in glee. Because the simple creatures hope he will impale his soul a topi on a tree. It seems such a shame when the English claim the earth, that they give rise to such hilarity and mirth. Mad dogs and Englishmen go out in the midday sun. The toughest Burmese bandit can never understand it. In Rangoon, the heat of noon is just what the natives shun. They put the Scotch or rye down and lie down. In a jungle town where the sun beats down to the rage of man and beast, the English garb of the English Saab merely gets a bit more creased. In Bangkok, at 12 o'clock, they foam at the mouth and run. But mad dogs and Englishmen go out in the midday sun. Mad dogs and Englishmen go out in the midday sun. The smallest Malay rabbit deplores this foolish habit. In Hong Kong, they strike a gong and fire off a noonday gun to reprimand each inmate who's in late. In the mangrove swamps where the python romps, there is peace from 12 to 2. Even caribous lie around and snooze, for there's nothing else to do. In Bengal, to move at all is seldom, if ever, done. But mad dogs and Englishmen go out in the midday, 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 out in the midday sun.
Ride with mother on her own. Looking good. Rosalind, can I now have the extended family to add to this picture that I've got for this? Okay, looking good. Can I have the bride while a girlfriend is here? Bride while a girlfriend. Best man? What a picture.
How dare you be so rude?
Oh, look, I see. It's
on
my way.
Oh, I'm sorry. The plumbing didn't look right from here.
No, no.
Hang on. This man's got a lot of wine. You spread out a bit more, girls.
Don't say that. Yeah.
Because you can spread out now, but when you get 40, it happens automatically because my wife is 40.
You cannot stop it.
Did you hear that? Ah, I like that. Which one's his husband, a wife? Okay,
for
a wide box. It's mine! Wow,
that'll go in
your
where is he, by the way?
Oh, Simon, darling.
Thank you. That's great. Okay, yeah, I'll see you gonna look at. You're gonna look at me. Get your bodies in closer. Okay, look towards me. Good. Okay. And just look.
Presents requested this evening, it's formal, a top hat, a white tie, and tails. Nothing now could take the wind out of my sails. Cause I'm invited to step out this evening with top hat, white tie, and tails. Oh, I'm putting on the top hat, tying up a white tie, brushing off my tails. I'm dudeing up my shirt front, putting in the shirt studs, polishing my nails. I'm stepping out, my dear, to breathe an atmosphere that simply reeks with class. And I trust that you'll excuse my dust when I step on the gas. For I'll be there, putting down my top hat, mussing up my white tie, dancing in my tail. Mussing up my white tie, dancing in my tails. Putting down my top hat, mussing up my white tie, dancing in my tails.
Really cute. wherever I look, I'm going your way. There's such a lot of work to see. We're after the same rainbows and waiting round the bend. My huckleberry friend, my huckleberry friend, Moon River, and
Moon. Say what her name is and all that. Midge. What's your name?
Daisy.
How old are you?
9.
Look at the camera. That's a one. What class are you in?
Year 5.
I'm not. I'd
imagine.
What's your bestest sport? Huh? What? What's your bestest sport?
No, you should say sport.
What's your favourite sport?
Football.
What's your favourite song?
It's Sam Panis from the choir.
Oh, life could be a dream if I could take you up in paradise up above. If you would tell me I'm the only one that you love, life could be a dream, sweetheart.
Hello, hello again.
Shaboom, and hope we'll meet again. Oh, life could be a dream if only all my precious plans would come true. If you would let me spend my whole life loving you, life could be a dream, sweetheart. Now every time I look at you, something is on my mind. If you do what I want you to,
baby, we'd be so far.
Oh, life could be a dream if I could take you up in paradise up above. If you would tell me I'm the only one that you love, life could be a dream, sweetheart.
Shaboom, shaboom,
now what will go down for popcorn?
Thank you.
The dawn of Carl's new life. Now, we are recording this for posterity, yeah. Right? Just in case I'm not recognised at the end of the show. I go through the running order. We go through the speeches, a toast at the end, and then the festivities will kick off. I'll go on late into the evening. The coach will leave 9:30. Party really starts then, kids. The bar will close at midnight, so I think we'll all like to respect the other guests in the establishment and the people, our your hosts here. Now, we've got the run of this room after it's all cleared, so you know there'll be music on and we can do what we like in here. The only thing that we need to keep clear is the area at the top, because we'll be setting that for breakfast. Now, looking around the room, I'm just dazzled by everybody's appearance here. It's like frocks on the box. I mean, you know, hats into the fore, everybody's out in the best here. You know, just totally dazzled by it all.
Especially Dawn, yeah.
Yeah. Outshone by everyone. Yeah, thank you. Yeah, if anybody wants to chip in any more, like, good remarks that I should have said, just please feel free. Yeah. Just keep it going. Right. Now, unfortunately, after the pleasure, it's been a really good day. Here comes the pain, and the pain is my speech. If you work with us, I'll give you the signal, laugh at the right time, and then we'll get through to the end. However, Carl, it's my privilege as the best man to say something in this joyous occasion. There's a number of people I'm sure they'll be talking to you throughout this evening that'd like to say a few things. At the end of this, if anybody feels the need to say anything, please feel free. Now, not many people know this, but today it's a monumental occasion. On this day, Mary, Queen Tudor, married Philip of Spain, and bloody oak flew the English Channel. But the thing I remember most is the day that Carl married Dawn. Well, first of all, they get married here, hop over the channel again, honeymoon in Switzerland. A real nice touch. However, in years to come, I want to be known as the person who said, I was here when it happened, the day Carl married Dawn.
Dear Carl got married.
Yeah.
Thought we'd never see it.
No, it had to be the right person, you know, and this is the right person. No. Now, while I remember this day, I've got a few messages from the people who won't remember the day, the people who unfortunately not going to be able to be with us today.
Oh, never invited
me. Yeah.
Wonder. Right. So I've got a message here to Carl and Dawn. Best wishes, Heather and Ian.
Wow.
Family friend, wishing you much happiness, Jack and Ivy.
Oh, Jack and Ivy.
A family friend. Love, Helen, Andrew, Anthony, Nick, Richard, Aisha. Oh, you got that one right. Another family friend. Congratulations. Love from Karen, Nick, Chris and Jenny.
Have they all written family friend in these cards?
No, Carl has.
Carl got the bloody card.
We're trying to be popular.
Here's a good look. Neighbours. From your neighbours, best wishes, Alan, Jan and Jess.
Oh, Jess is the dog.
Oh, right.
Jess is the dog. Sophie's friend.
Oh, is Sophie and Jess going to get together then? Yeah. From Carl's overtaxed accountant. Or should that be, he should be overtaxed. Wishing you both a very happy wedding day and many years of happiness together, Peter and Marion Collins.
Ah,
the old speed. Oh, a bit of a rude card here, don't know if this is things to come tonight. To have it the hall. Hot from the dog's uncle. Oh, yes. Hoping you have a really lovely day. Best wishes, Wayne, Chris, Jessica. So we stop there, send a big woof woof. Well, from my Aunt Vera and Uncle Eric, best wishes for today.
Someone else sent that card, you know.
I had a job lot in the booth.
For anyone who forgot.
Yeah, from a brother, Colin, and his little daughter, Emily. Congratulations on your day.
What about his wife?
Catherine, yeah. And daughter, and Colin. Congratulations to you on this day, and all the best for the future. There's love on your wedding day. Hope you'll have a long and happy life together. Lots and lots of love. Carol, Jeff, Abigail, Andrew and Millie.
Oh, no. That's a dog. Millie the
dog. Oh, another dog. The dogs are getting a big club tonight.
Oh, I've got no friends, you see.
Get your dogs here.
Two cards here.
One each.
Yeah. Which one first? Which one first? Slaphead. Two Slaphead. Right. To Carl, in case anybody knows. He's wishing you the best day ever and an ace life with a top dolly bird. Hey. Hey. Top dolly bird. Yeah. Love the Clems.
Was that off done?
To Scrumptious Bum. To our Dawn, who's wishing you and your lad ace nuptials, swear down, love the Clems. Another one to the happy couple. From Simon's mother, best wishes on your special day from Rita with love.
Yeah.
I wish I realised it was like this earlier in the evening.
That's from a fan, is it?
Yeah. From a big fan, yes. To Dawn and Carl from Karen and Darren. Have lots of
and
loving.
Sharon.
No, I don't think Sharon's quite on right. Yeah, yeah. Have lots of loving Sharon and lots of...
Spell a mistake.
You're right, yeah. Looking, I should say.
Thank you very much.
Yeah, we've well, known that. We won't go with that one.
I'm dyslexic.
Yeah.
Thank you very much.
Here we are. The two of the most special people. Have a great life together. You were made for each other.
Oh,
oh yeah.
Yeah,
we couldn't agree more. More with that one.
Definitely.
From David, Michelle, Stacey and Lisa.
Oh,
we're going to break down.
That's nice.
You're coming that clapped out of here.
Still see, there you go.
For both of you on your marriage, to Carl and Dawn, wishing you a world of happiness. All our love, Susie, Simon and the girls. Now, it's not last but least, to Dawn and Carl, wishing you both every happiness today and in the future, all my love, Mum.
Aww.
Another one, a big love. Congratulations with love. Best wishes always, Mum.
Well,
a nice thank you from both mums there. Well, in case you got away with it lightly, Carl, you know, just got to take you back a few little years. Yeah. Oh, yes, yeah, certainly. I mean, you said you didn't want to be embarrassed on your wedding day, but let's face it, you can't be embarrassed on your wedding day. When can you be embarrassed?
Your wedding days.
Don't you?
Is that the voice of experience?
Yeah. Yeah. Cheating,
yeah. I remember a certain young guy many years ago back at the MOD in Eaglescliff. He had an eye on a certain young girl even then. But with the MOD, as you can imagine, ships pass in the night quite frequently. Things never go according to plan.
Usually they crash. Yeah.
Yeah. Well, that's unfortunate. Yeah. Yeah. Now, unfortunately, they missed their way for a while, and a number of years gone by. But all not over yet. Now, Carl, he never found anybody that you know he could sign up to. Now, I know that Carl went through a period where he was certain of his life. He was not the kind that was ever going to get married.
No.
He knew where he was going, and I remember. When I got married, you know, the famous words come out, that will never be me, I will not be joining you. As each of his friends went down, we all found our partners. We all found our perfect partners and we got married. Carl was insistent all through this. He would never go through this. Now, my wife at the, you know, went through it and said, well, don't knock it till you've tried it.
They're not.
Yeah. Yeah, Carl was certain marriage was not for him. Not for all the tea in China. But, wham, if it's love, isn't it time to make a fresh start with a girl from Bar's house? As I've got to say, Carl, for every Jack, there's a Jill. For every Vic, there's a Bob. For every Liam, there's a Patsy, and for every car
you
there's a dog.
You put pasty down there.
Yeah. I was scratching these notes at the late hour.
For every Liam there's a pasty.
Yeah. But when two people are meant to be together, nothing is keeping them apart. You've had a long road to get together, but I'm glad you've made it in the end.
Steady. Oh, dear. Yeah. Nice cup of orange juice.
All I'd like to say is to bring you with a quotation. The Reverend Sidney Smith once remarked, marriage resembles a pair of shears, so joined that they cannot be separated, often moving in separate directions, yet always punishing anyone who cares to come between them. And I think that's the way it will be with yourselves. Two perfect people, suited together. I'd like to end the speech with a bit of sparkle. So please raise your glasses. There should be some wine on the table. And propose a toast again. To the perfect couple on the perfect day.
Oh, yes.
Cheers. Your best life together.
Cheers.
Carl and Dawn.
Cheers.
Cheers. Cheers.
Cheers.
Cheers.
Cheers.
Cheers.
Cheers.
Cheers.
Lovely.
Oh, nice one. Good.
So here you are, it's poison. Excuse me. It's poison chalice time because I came for a nice relaxed weekend and I'm strolling around the countryside this morning with Carl. And he says, oh, would you know, do you fancy getting up and saying a few words? Don't say anything embarrassing, very difficult. And keep it short and sweet. So I've got to fill about 2 minutes. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to find my suit jacket in. I've worn this suit for about 2 years. And I get this out of the dry cleaner's wrapper, and I'm halfway down the bloody stairs. I'm welcoming people off the coach. What the bloody hell are these? That's got rid of 15 seconds. For goodness sake, you just send those down the line. Now also in this jacket, I've got to fill the next minute and a half, so I've got to share something with you that happened at breakfast, because there's about a dozen of us staying here. And we drank and ate with the kids as well till about 12:30 last night, and we all agreed to get down for 9 o'clock for breakfast. And we come down to breakfast, and let me share with you the perfect couple's introduction to their wedding day. Dawn Elizabeth Fibus. Nice warm bath, gets into it, meditating there. Very pleasant. Opens her eyes to see Carl. Naked. Apart from some horn rim spectacles, rather like these. In the name of exercise, hopping across the bedroom floor. Now the thing I want to know is, where were the spectacles? Was he doing his world famous Woody Allen impression?
Remember that again?
I tell you what I want to say. I want to pay tribute to changing families. I want to pay tribute to enduring friendships. And to Carl and Dawn.
Sorry,
I've got to turn the beer to you. I'll just send the pacemaker back to Carl. Yeah, he might need to get his rhythm.
Turn it down.
We're here.
Wait a minute, the 10th page is this.
Little speech I concocted earlier today.
Oh, in your dream.
Told you it was 10 pages.
People who know me actually at these occasions will know that I can't speak in normal sense, so I tend to get all my words across in rhyme. It's probably dating back to my band days. I find it much easier to speak like this. And I hope there's one or two things here that will ring true with you all. Where do I begin to tell the story of how great a love can be? Oh yeah, I remember now, 1980 in the MOD. That's where I first saw Dawn in personnel. She was passing round the opal fruits. She was sporting a fringe with a 2-inch gap and real leather kinky black boots. Right from the start, we got on great, and I made my intentions plain. Get yourself round tonight, I said, because my mum and dad are in Spain.
You got it, Mum.
But I'm glad to say Dawn was a nice girl. Never mind how my hormones raged. She wouldn't succumb to a bounder like me, especially one who was engaged. But the fun we had in those depot days, we did so little work it was fraud. We did tea break quizzes that lasted all week, and we danced around the boss while he snored. It's a true story, that. It's true.
Another true story. They're all true.
So this is where it all started. Two kids in the civil service. Dawn was my Val Singleton, and I was her Peter Purvis. But being just a slip of a lad, love and stuff made me all surly. I kind of knew then that Dawn was the one. She was just 15 years too early. So with the carelessness of youth, I let my chance slip by. Dawn got married to a gloating stoat while I gave pop stardom a try. Years went by and life moved on. Through my mind she occasionally flashed. We're here. Whatever happened... Whatever happened to my likely lass, last heard of, somewhere in the past. Let's flip forward now several years. It's 1993. Mr. Fate had chosen that date to jump right out on me. Our old mate Si, who isn't here, the bastard.
Well, hey.
Sorry, I'm not sure.
Just cut it out. Our old mate Si had taken Dawn in. She was like a waif and stray. Her marriage had sunk like a Titanic trunk, and I thought, how sad. Hooray! Remembering all those years ago and how I dilly-dallied, I booled straight in with a Friday night date and made sure my pass was valid. I took her out to the Fox and Hounds. I put on my loudest shirt. She poured out her heart for over 4 hours and I kissed her where it hurt.
Ooh.
The rest, as they say, the rest, as they say, is history. We've been together ever since. We go together like Vera and Jack, Ted and Dougal, Penny and Vince. We've got so much in common. We're both nearly 40 for a start. Dawn's never modelled for Westwood, and I've never been top of the charts. We're both as blind as proverbial bats. As a chore-dodging wheeze, it's a must. We can't even make out our four-foot-high shelves, so we certainly can't see any dust. You could say we're both on a wavelength. We've definitely got similar tastes. Chicken masala, tortilla chips, that's why we've got similar waists. We're like flying off to Italy and or walking the dog in the Dales. We're like trying on old men's cardigans in the Oxfam January sales. We love Lewis Carroll and carry-ons and recording crazy pop tunes. We're heavily into literature, the TV Times and the Bruins. We like little antique shops down little back lanes. We like Scooby-Doo socks on our feet. We adore Jeff doing our garden while we sit in watching the street. We love looking through old photographs and the lens of a Pentax or Nikon. If all this lovely stuff's making me ill, we'll pass on a plate to be sick on. No, we're not claiming continual bliss. You'd quite rightly treat that with scorn. So let's take a peek at a typical week with 10 things you never knew about Dawn. Right, she's not the most active of women. It's exhausting painting your nails. She'll occasionally run up the stairs to hide the bathroom scales. Dawn's a very low threshold of boredom. She did a fashion course up at the college. She made half a skirt and a sleeve for a shirt and she hasn't been back to my house. Now, I'm a very tidy man.
Oh,
I know what cupboards are for. Dawn likes everything in its place too, usually the bedroom floor.
Something wrong with that.
Dawn's secret world is the bathroom. On her lotions and creams, she's reliant. The room's only small, but it's stocked wall to wall like some pharmaceutical giant. And speaking of all matters bathroom, it's not too much to ask, I don't think. Dawn, now we're married, is there any chance you'll declog your hair from the sink?
None.
Or if you declog yours.
I'm an even-tempered man. I don't let anything faze me. But when Dawn sees red, best take to your bed because she'll outrant Ian Paisley. Now, as every man in the room will know, the one thing you must never dare is insinuate in the slightest way there's something wrong with your woman's hair. She'll stamp around with a face like hell or else the tears will come. But Dawn even resorts to cruelty. At least I've still bloody got some.
Hey.
It's time now to say a few thank yous. I will start with our two guests of honour. That's our brilliant mums with their beads and their rums. They've more razzmatazz than Madonna. I haven't finished yet.
Oh, good morning.
That was six, was it?
And hey, what about our bridesmaids? Oh. Five go wild on the moor. They're pretty, they're cute, they're streetwise to boot. You've seen the new Spice Girls, I'm sure. Big round of applause. A big special thanks to Dave, my best man, and to Jeff for being my usher. It was funny to see two grown men fight for the privilege of applying my blusher. Not forgetting, of course, our fabulous guests, our families, colleagues and friends. Your presents were certainly different. We'll always treasure our Tinky Winky bookends. Thank you. Sincere thanks too to the hotel and staff, and to Chris for our Wonderland cake. Where's Chris?
Hey, Chris!
Sophie the dog for sleeping right through, and to Nan for staying awake.
Yeah. Do you want me to slap it? I like it.
I'll get him in a minute.
Weddings by nature are emotional things. What's happiness without the odd tear? So today, of all days, how could we forget the two guests who couldn't be here? I'm talking, of course, of our two dear old dads. How poignant might it have been to see them stood there, champagne in the air, toasting the new Mrs. Green. So finally back to the lady of the hour, my wonderful, lovely new wife. I promised I wouldn't embarrass her, but I will. She's the love of my life. Thank you all once again for sharing our day. It's been better than even we hoped. We'd have been poorer without this experience, but far richer if we'd eloped. Thank you. I do sit down. I'd like you all to raise your glasses once more to our bridesmaids, and ask the bridesmaids to come down because we've got something to present to them. So, and to the bridesmaids, be happy!
Yay! Yay! Oh, good.
Adopting, cut the crap and give me the present.
You have to move your chair
far because
we have to go
on
that.
Oh, wait, we're going
there.
Now.
Oh, it's like the World Cup.
Hey!
Come on. Final presentations. I mentioned a bag full of goodies here. I mentioned before my best man Dave has done a great job, and to Jeff, they've actually made sure today's gone really, really well. They've worked extremely hard on behalf of me and Dawn. We couldn't have done it without them, and I'd like to present them a small token of our esteem.
Well done. Well done.
It's like Christmas here, isn't it? It hasn't just been, Jeff and Dave have been helping out. So there's a little present there for Carol, who's also been working very hard. And finally, a bit of a surprise for Mark and Linda as well, who's Mark who made the speech there. And I'm going to give it to Linda, otherwise I'll never
see you all again. Otherwise you'll get your balls gone.
Right, that's it. I feel
quite a bit than that.
Well, there's more in my pocket.
That's where I'm at anyway, so I do hope you've enjoyed yourselves. And we're going to retire to the bar soon, so...
No, we're
going to stay in here. We'll see you later for some mutual backslapping and much joviality. Thank you very much indeed.
Well done. Well done.
Tears to fall, but it's all in the game. All in the wonderful game that we know as love. You have words with him, and your future's looking dim. But these things your heart can rise above. Once in a while he won't call, but it's all in the game. Soon he'll be there at your side with a sweet bouquet, and he'll kiss your lips and caress your wedding fingertips, and your heart will fly. I see trees of green, red roses too. I see them bloom for me and you. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. I see skies of blue and clouds of white, the bright blessed day, the dark sacred night. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. the colors of the rainbow, so pretty in the sky, are also on the faces of people going by. I see friends shaking hands, saying, how do you do? They're really saying, I love you. I hear babies cry. I watch them grow. They're like much more than I ever knew. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. Yes, I think to myself, what a wonderful world.